Hi, welcome to an AutoCAD 2019 video tutorial. I want to do the rear wing exercise, the last one in this series now in AutoCAD. Let's take a look. I want to use the free orbit. It went quite well, apart from the thickening, and I couldn't do the chamfers because there was no option with two dimensions. I could try with an angle and dimension, but let's have fun with AutoCAD. Let's start with some, let's say, sketches. I need a square which goes from 0, 0 up to 650:650. Then I need a spline. I will go for method of CV, not a fit. Let's start here, go over here, maybe like this, go for the nearest point, okay, and enter. Then I can adjust this a little bit, maybe like this, okay. I need a line, maybe like that, and another rectangle, a fillet, radius might be 100, like that, then move from that point here up. This one, then trim, select the objects, right click, and now trim. This one. Okay, I want to make it a polyline. I could convert this into polyline, but I will make this a polyline. So go for P edit. Join. Enter. Okay. Next, I need an arc, a 3-point arc, which goes from here, maybe like this. Okay. I will need an offset curve, so maybe 20 from this one in that direction. And for the moment, yeah, I need lines. So this should be on. And I need a line from 0, 0 up there, maybe 800 in length. Then I need an offset line with 100. Then another one with 135, sorry, 135, once, twice, three times, and a fourth time. Now I want to rotate my axis system around the Y axis. So 90 degrees, and then I want to look at That would be 375 column 0, straight up, maybe again 800. Another line which starts at 200. So in that direction, 200, so I would go for maybe 320 column 200, maybe like this. Okay, and I might need another line here, so I go for a line, maybe like this. Okay, now I have to rotate my axis system once more. Let's take a look. I need it on the XZ plane, so I have to rotate it around the X axis. Yes, select it and turn it around the X axis by 90 degrees, and let's take a look, because sometimes that's misleading. So in this case I have to go onto this side. I need a rectangle. Which might be in this case 20 by 135. Okay, let's switch on parametric constraints and give it, yeah, let's go for auto constraint just in case. Hide those. Now give it a dimension, 135, yes, repeat, in that direction it could be 20. Let's take a look, and it has to be a polyline which starts here, goes over there, maybe just maybe 30, then into an arc and back into another arc. Enter. Now let's give it a dimension. Okay, add a tangency up here. Now let's position that rectangle correct and this should be at, so go for move, or maybe first hide those constraints. Now go for a move. I want to move these elements, right click. The base point should be this one, click, and now move it to hashtag 375 column 100. That should be the correct position. I will need a copy of this one. So Control C, Control V, and this should be put somewhere else. So go for move, right click, base point should be this one, and this should go to hashtag 375 column 0, enter. Seems I'm not able to put in the right values, so I will try it once more. Okay, this one, right click, base point should be that one, should go to hashtag 375 column 0, enter. That's more like it. Yeah, now let's show those dimensions, and this should be not 30 but maybe 20, and this could be, let's try 100, yeah, but that point here should be on that point there. So go for coincidence, this point on that point. Of course it moved, and I need tangency between this one and that one. Now let's move this once more. So this should be moved, right click, from this point to that one. Hide those and those as well. So it's slightly, just slightly, I don't know how this happened, because usually this works very good. So we'll go for another move. Let's move these, right click, from that point to this one. That's okay. Then switch back to the world coordinate system. Go for top. Now I should be able to switch back. Okay, and I need some more sketches. Let's go for an arc from this point right here over there, and maybe like this, another arc, maybe like that. Then I need some rectangles. Give it dimensions, hide all, linear, this might be 15, this might be 15, might be 15 as well. Distance between those should be 15. Let's move this a little bit down, so go for 15 as well. Now we should be able to move it a little bit. Maybe like this. And now I should have done all my sketches. Yeah. So I will save this. That's the ending of the first part. So if you liked it, please give it a like or leave a comment. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. And thanks for watching. See you to the next one, which will be part 2 of this exercise.